we look forward to the conference because it's our chance to hear from you, our customers and partners, about what's really on your mind. And it's an opportunity for us to say thank you for all the business that you do with us and to provide a small update on our business. Of course, over the next 3 days, you'll have a chance to talk with some, if not all, of the key leaders in our company, test drive some of our latest products in hands-on labs, and attend breakout sessions to learn real wearable techniques for implementing our technologies. But right now, what I'd like to do is talk with you about where we believe information technology is going and what solutions we can provide so that you can make the most of that direction. Now, you may not know this, Enrique told you, but this does mark two very important milestones for us. It's the 10th anniversary of Vision, and it's the 25th anniversary of the founding of Symantec. It was born in 1982 as a company, and looking back over the past 25 years, our industry has gone through an enormous amount of change. The Commodore 64 hit the market in 1982. Remember those? It had 64K of RAM, and over its 11-year history, it became the best-selling single computer model of all time. In 1982, it was also the year that the Osborne 1 was born. Remember that? Some of you do. I do. It had a 5-inch display screen, and it weighed 24 pounds. It was more lovable than portable. And most of all, 1982 was the year that Time magazine broke with decades of precedent and named not a person of the year, but a machine of the year in the personal computer. The magazine writers declared, "The information revolution has arrived, bringing with it the promise of dramatic change in the way people live and work, perhaps even in the way we think. America will never be the same." Well, they were right. America and the world has never been the same ever since. Back then, they marveled at the idea that 1,500 databases were accessible via dial-up modem. Yet Times readers could never have imagined that 25 years later, with a broadband connection and a powerful search engine, I would be able to find that very article in less than 1 second. The magazine described a small pocket of programmers and executives who were working under a whole new arrangement called telecommuting. Clearly, Time was onto something. But I don't think that they or anyone else could have imagined the transformation that we've experienced over the last 25 years. Today's extended enterprises include employees, partners, suppliers, customers, collaborating across all time zones with laptops, BlackBerries, on email, on IM, using wikis, just to name a few. Now, we're living in the era of more collaboration and more online interactions, in an era of where truly the user is in charge. It's no wonder that when Time magazine chose its Person of the Year for 2006, the editors recognized this shift, and guess what? They chose you. Indeed, the growth of the connected world has blurred the lines between enterprises and consumers. New business models, from 24/7 R&D organizations to global supply chains, are introducing new ways of serving customers. And it's safe to say that information technology is at the center of every single business today. IT systems are now essential drivers of collaboration, innovation, and growth. And at Symantec, we believe that all of us should be free to work and play. And to make the most of that, we believe that one thing is truly, truly essential, and that's confidence. Enterprises need to be confident that their software will help to keep their systems up and their data secure. They need to be confident that they can make information available when and where it's needed. And they need to be confident that they're getting the most out of their IT investment. Consumers need similar confidence. They need to be confident that the information they're providing online, the interactions that they're having online, and the various devices that they're using while they're online are both secure and reliable. However, for enterprises and consumers alike, gaining this confidence isn't that easy. the exponential growth in information has fueled equally explosive growth in infrastructure complexity. At the same time, it's magnified the risk to security, availability, performance, and compliance. IT leaders recognize that the convergence of security, storage, and systems management is, in fact, a reality in today's IT market. That the domains of security and infrastructure management are indelibly intertwined, and that you can't separate security risk from the application or the infrastructure. As a result, we've seen a fundamental shift. Businesses are now focused more on managing risk across their organization than managing devices. To help them do this, we've seen an even more explosive growth and change in the way organizations are aligned. Some customers have created a new position, a position called the Chief Risk Officer. Whether you've taken that step or not, our goal is to provide you with the solutions you need